Hello friends, welcome to this channel Gain Java Knowledge, and today we are going to discuss Java most important topic, that is inheritance, and we can also say is a relationship. So first I will explain what is inheritance and what are the main rules to define inheritance, and after that we will write the code. And now we will start. First, what is a relationship? Is a relationship is also known as inheritance, and by using extend keywords we can implement is a relationship. By using extends keyword we can implement is a relationship. For example, here is a class P, we can say its parent class, and one another class, that is child class, extending our parent class. Then by default all method available in parent class will be in child class. And the main advantage of is a relationship is reusability of the code. And now we will discuss the rule. Let us see in the code, then I will define the rule. Here I have created one class, test class, and now I will create one child class and one parent class. Here I am creating a parent class, and in now I am going to create one child class that will extend our parent class. And inside parent class no method I have defined. Now I will define one method, that is property method in parent class. And inside child class I will define one method, that is job method, because parent have properties and inside child have job. Now I will printing the value system.out.println property, and inside child class I have printed job. Now all methods available in parent class by default will be available in child class, because child class extending parent. Here we can expect property method is also available in child class. And if by creating our child class reference we can call parent class methods also. Now I am going to call the child class method. Here I have declared main method, and here I have created parent class reference variable. First I will tell you the rules. After that I will show you in the code how it will work. And the main rules of inheritance is whatever methods declared in parent class will be available in child class. Hence on the child class reference we can call both parent class and child class method. So first we will see first rule in code. By using child class reference we can call parent class object also. Here I will show you the method present in parent class we can call by using child class reference variable, and we can call both methods. Now I will run this application. Run as Java application. Here we can see the output property and job. By using child class reference variable we can call both methods that are available in parent class and available in child class. Now we will see the second rule. Second rule, whatever methods child class has by default not available in parent class, hence on the parent reference we can not call child specific method. To second rule, the methods available in child class not will be available in parent class. So if we create parent class object, then we cannot call child class object. We can call only parent class object, that is property method, and we cannot call child object. Here if we will call this method, then it will show compile time error. because we cannot call child class method by using parent class reference variable, and it was the second rule. And now we will see the third rule. And according to third rule, parent reference can be used to hold child object, but by using parent reference we can call only methods available in parent class, and we cannot call child specific method. Let us check in the code. According to third rule, parent class reference can hold child class object. It's holding child class object, and but we can call only parent class object p dot property, but we cannot call child class method, that is job method. We cannot call this method according to third rule, and it's right. We cannot call child class specific method by using parent reference variable. And now we will see the fourth rule. And the fourth rule is that parent reference can be used to hold child object, but child reference cannot be used to hold parent object. And it was a fourth rule. We will check here. According to fourth rule, child class of reference cannot hold parent class object. Yeah, it's not, it cannot hold, it's need to typecast. So according to fourth rule, it's true. Parent reference can be used to hold child object, but child reference cannot be used to hold parent object. And it was the four main rule for inheritance, and the main purpose of inheritance only code reusability. Okay, thanks.